He's the one that's, that does the text to the final thesis.
He'll grab on Notre Dame anytime if we're over there on Curry. It'll be a bigger story for Notre Dame. If Curry would have won, it'd been a little bitty thing.
We got 17. Valley's winning today. Oh, Valley's gonna be. Who does Valley play if they win?
Don't know. Can't answer that. I don't know any of that.
Thanks, man. Oh, probably not. Well, it'll be burning.
Just the start of the night.
What happens if they hit it and it goes into the basketball hoop next?
Well, I don't know if you can play it off or not.
I mean, will they award a point?
That are dead.
But if you hit it and it goes in the net, it should be like what you need for it. So if it goes in the basketball,
it don't work like that.
That would be a question for Misha.
I'd say it's a dead ball.
Coach Mosca, that's what's in my handy last night. Maryville football coach.
What about
it? John was watching that candy.
He did.
Yeah.
Who did they play last night? St. Jim? Okay, St. Jim told me.
Arch rivalry. That's our arch rivalry. Man, I still can't believe I got my 10-year this year.
10-year reunion, huh, buddy?
It's at the winery, and it's open to the public, $5.
What winery is it?
Warren Barrett. You guys can come out.
Who's playing?
The Hotop Boys.
The Hotop Boys, really?
4 years apart. It'll probably be inside.
That place ain't big enough. I'd have it set up outside.
Well, it's from 17 to 11.
I think you'll have more people coming to it if it was that way, you know. I think you'll have a good turnout.
Remember, I am recording this. Yeah. Well, it picks up the sound from them. No. I mean, you're fine.
so happy. This is some really good pizza.
$2.
They better make sure they got a lot from Mayor's Cup.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, they already released the dates of the next year's volleyball tournament. Yeah. It's going to be the third. Next year. Cousin in Indiana. That school. If their football team can outmatch Valley. They were state champions in swimming and like everything. But like, Dryer, what do you think if we can get a business to like promote them to get them to come? That'd be something.
I'm just saying, school like that.
They're in Indiana. They're in the same class as we are in football. Yeah. It's a Catholic school, Evansville Memorial. It's a Memorial. I think last year at one point they were 17-3.
Thank you.
score of entrance.
Valley Catholic 7, Saxton 4.
Thank you.
Currently, we are joining for pods now as time is running low, and we still have one more game with Valley Catholic.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry about that time constraints issue. So, well, three games to go. Perryville just got eliminated. The winner of this game, Valley Catholic and Barney Mules, will be playing the Advance Hornets. Oh man, that beat just stung me again. It was not no bee, it was that hornet. Well, he's got a 5.5-1 lead currently here in this contest. So we will have now the championship game because hopefully our friend from St. Genevieve is going to hang out here in this game. Going to be playing for the volleyball tournament. Hey, at least the referees get a chance to relax. They've been going all day. I mean, we've been going since 8:30 a.m. and folks, it's 5-something. A lot of these kids, you know, put their effort into it. I got a question. We got over roughly a month. Until next year, because or roughly a year, because next year's tournament will be October 3rd of 2020. Here's a question. We know Advance will be back, probably in the Final Four. What do you guys think about? You know, we try to get a team in here that can. Outplay them for a chance to see them lose in four straight years. I'm thinking that sounds pretty good. I mean, you know, the Evansville Memorial Tigers are out there in Evansville, Indiana, and I know a couple of years ago, last year, they were 17-3 at one point, according to Twitter. So I think we're going to have to check to see what they think about maybe making the trip. It is $150 to get in. So just wondering what everybody else thinks, but that's a 4-hour bus ride. Hey, I got news for you. If Valley Catholic loses, it'll be a Starr County, Missouri final. If Valley Catholic loses, Starr County is guaranteed to win the Perryville Volleyball Tournament Championship. The 2019 Perryville Volleyball Tournament Championship. But the Burning Mules have a lot of work to do. As they currently lead 8-2. Excuse me, deficit 8-2. Make that 9-2. Four for Valley. Sorry, that thing. Valley's Libera puts it up. Four gets a ride. 24. Point for the Valley Catholic Warriors. That's a point. 10-2. Valley Catholic. 2-10. Valley Catholic. That's right. Valley Catholic 10. Bernie's Mules Starr County. As the mules want to definitely talk about it before they start doing the mule jump. It'll be September 20th, something like that. Next year's East Prairie Community Food, not Bird. Here you can see the mules jump, and they're not from Bernie, Missouri, or Bernard. You could also known as Bernard. Cuddy is all by himself over there, and man, I better get these scores up to date here on the senior ball. Southeast Missouri. So it's down to three teams. Perryville's been eliminated. And we're still here. We covered a championship game. Number 15, who has got a little bit of Kagan power in there with that point. I got a chance to talk to her, and she said, cool, but, you know, myself and her mom might be cousins. Her mom is Amy Kagan, by the way. It was Amy Kagan. Drury. Amy Drury. You don't see Sydney Bosler anymore. So Valley's probably thinking, man, if we win, we're going to call her up and say, man, it's a good thing we don't have you anymore because we know how to beat our fans. I mean, they did beat Jackson Indians once again. Jackson lost or beat Advance. I was wondering last night, you know, could that be the thing that pushes Valley Catholic past Advent? So I'm like, nah, I don't know if they can get past Paragon. Valley is 15 or 10 points away from advancing to the final for the next round. Make that 14. I am going to take a timeout. I know you all are enjoying watching this volleyball game, but hey, we got a championship game to go. I mean, not timeout on the camera, but just timeout.
Thank you. Yeah, Advent
and spend it the last 2 years before that Valley money that we need. I forgot who Valley beat. I could have gotten it. Too bad we can't put teams like in Elias down there. And, you know, big schools like them. I could get a team out of the game over there. Kind of school going on. Football program actually could match Valley by 10 points better.
Match point here in match number one. Match point, Valley. Oh, so close, number four. Valley. Oh my goodness, Siebert. Libero now four. Can they drop? Valley's gonna win their first match. They are going to switch. Valley is 25 points away from advancing to the championship game. They won it 3 years ago. Can they do it again? Siebert's going to come over here and talk to Mom. Mom's going to give her some advice. Stacy Sargent is grinning from ear to ear. One little fan got so tired, it's like, man, it's been a long day for me, Mom. Last little one remaining here. Yeah, that's a lifeguard. Still a Dexter Bearcat person here. They lost a while ago. Cody. Cody's all alone. He's like, Man, I need some friends. Here, we'll give you a shot. There he is. That's Cody with Sima Ball. He's the one that gets you all their text you need. Says, Valley defeats an advance in the Perryville Volleyball Tournament. Oh, thank you, Cody. Yeah. I'm sure are you? Well, not that true. Never. Probably on Twitter currently talking to everybody at SEMO Ball down there in advance. If they got internet reception. Okay. So we're going to be back for the championship game here in about 45, half an hour. Who's going to win it? You'll find out that. All right, man, that was a. Too bad we didn't film that first. So I'm out of breath yelling. Their mission is to lose to the Valley Catholic Warriors. Alright, folks, it's gonna get loud, so get your earplugs in there. You're gonna need them. And I'm actually going to step aside so you don't hear my voice in the camera. You may hear Anthony's. You may hear this young lady way over there yelling. abusive words. Valley takes the first point. Man, 24 points away from winning the volleyball tournament. Oh, my goodness. St. Genevieve, I know it's St. Jen's homecoming, but hey, Valley's saying we're going to wrap your homecoming weekend up with a nice volleyball championship party for the city of St. Genevieve. As that lady makes noise again, so you know what that means. That fans gets a point. Man, Cody over there said, man, I thought you were rooting for both teams. Well, don't worry, we've been rooting for them fairly. Unlike that fan. So I'm going to get off the head.
Let's go, Kelly! Y'all are going to win it. Thank you. Let's go!
of course, that was Anthony Teeter making all sorts of noises. Valley scores again and advances. Fane has not decided to waver to Rally Town for a little bit. Looks like she's on her phone texting somebody and saying, hey, I want to see Valley win. Valley's down but two away from losing. Valley is 10 points away from their second win in the Perryville Volleyball Tournament since it existed. But Advance is 1-1. Guys, girls, I don't know what to do. I think we need to, you know, contact a team out, you know, maybe try to get Jackson up here to beat them. Arcadia Valley can't beat them. What about somebody in Jefferson City? And Advance is going to win the Perryville Volleyball Tournament. Thank you to the referees. Valley takes second place. Dexter JV won their event. Advance won, and so long from the Perryville Parks, and they're from Volleyball Action. Good night, everybody, and have a safe trip home.